Subora against Vera is brought to you by Monster Energy.
Look for Vera to keep the distance, land some leg kicks. After talking with him a little bit, he's going to stay on the outside, throw some leg kicks to the takedowns there. He'll take it. There he goes. Look for Subora to step in big with some big punches, try and get the knockout. Oh, rocked him already.
Top of the head, and it sent Subora back to the cage
big,
wall.
Big knees, knees to the in the clinch.
Three knees to the head. The crowd going absolutely crazy here in Manila. Is this going to be a quick finish?
Brent is doing work right now. He needs to get back on that head kick again. Maybe set it up with a low and then go back up top.
Subora is hurt. He's grimacing despite that flying punch that he just tried. Boom. Takes a big kick to the midriff. But he's still punching back. Vera still throwing those kicks there to the inside of the thigh.
Brent is just picking him apart right now. Subora needs to actually back away.
Subora grimaces again. He's suffering pain somewhere. Nice short right hand from the Ukrainian. Solid ramrod jab from Vera.
Brandon's got to keep those hands up, though. Igor's still dangerous. It's first round, it's still fresh. Brandon's pawn on the outside a little bit. But then probably go to the body, the inside of the leg again. You can tell he's getting ready to throw that kick. Brandon needs to keep those hands up tight, though. Igor's recovered now, he's feeling fresh.
Both men swinging, both men just ducking under the punches. Heavyweights, it could finish any second. Big man can get that leg up really high. Oh, right hand and a left as well from Subora.
Subora's bleeding a little bit from the tip, the bridge of his nose.
Eagle's a little bit uncomfortable with something. He's been practicing for a while now, and it could be the nose that's causing him trouble.
Got a little bit of redness around the left eye as well. Brandon keeps switching stance, keeping Igor thrown off a little bit. Subora's still dangerous. He's coming in with that big right. This is what he said he was going to do.
Oh, kick to the midriff. And that kick just above the knee that could hyperextend it. Damaging kick, that is. Straight pushes the thigh back, locks the knee up. Good left hand from Igor. Sent Brandon back a pace. Looks for it again. Leaps in with it. Nice high guard from Brandon Vera. Left hand again from the Ukrainian. Oh, right hand, it was a good one.
Brandon stepping in, throwing those short little choppy elbows. Stan on the outside, really executing his game plan to a T right now. I talked to him the other day. He said this was exactly what he wanted to do.
Brandon looking for the left hand downstairs. Gets clipped by a couple. Oh, left hand.
It's over now. Olivier Costa sitting up.
Watch out for the fast start from Christian Lee. It's very much his signature. He doesn't hang about.
By Christian Lee. He's actually slowed down quite a bit. He's kind of understanding composure and how to be relaxed, but he can explode at any minute.
Oh,
and
a right hand
landed by Martin Nguyen.
Really cuffed him, didn't he? Got a clean shot in there. By far the biggest step up for Christian Lee is what Martin Nguyen represents. And Christian got back in with a left hand there that also caught his opponent fairly cleanly. So a good punch each from these men in the opening seconds.
That overhand right is real dangerous from Nguyen because Christian kind of keeps his posture really high and his head looks like it's really elevated, so he doesn't kind of tuck the chin in. So he's susceptible to that overhand right from Martin Nguyen.
It's Lee very much in pursuit mode, as we thought it might be.
Nice catch there on the kick, spins around, takes control, and this is where Martin Nguyen wants to get this fight. He wants to make it dirty, wants to make it gritty, and he likes to drag these fights down to the ground. Trying to single leg, big takedown, but Christian pops right back up.
He did so well to land on his feet there. Looked promoted as if he'd be landing on his head.
Very
athleticism
agile.
And flexibility, agility, that's right, exactly the word we were looking for.
There's another one of those big right hands coming from Nguyen, but Christian ducks under it. We have ourselves a fight, folks.
What an arc to that uppercut from Nguyen, which I'm not sure that it connected, but sent out a message, didn't it?
When I saw this fight on the card, I knew that this one could be the Fun 88 fight of the night.
What a decent overhand right that was from Nguyen as Lee came in.
He's thrown out a stiff jab there. He's got an awkward guard. You know, he keeps a very wide guard, very wide stance. Not your typical boxing stance or Muay Thai stance.
Good left jab from Lee there, but it's that counter overhand right from Nguyen that he's got to be careful of when he throws that jab.
Nice, I like how he threw that overhand right, stepped forward with the right foot, and then came with a left overhand.
And Lee's been quite adept just in the last 20 seconds of getting out of the way. But he caught that one and went down and bounced straight back up again.
That's it, man. Christian's got to get his chin down. His head's really high in the air. And Nguyen is taking advantage of that with these big overhands.
Can't take your eyes off this one for a second. Good ramrod left jab from Christian Lee.
Now Christian's starting to get a little bit more compact in his stance. Again, another overhand right,
kick.
Steve.
Yeah, he threw the kick and was exposed to the right hand, wasn't he? These counters from Nguyen are expert punches.
Will we see Christian Lee in the second round? And that's the question on everybody's mind.
The energy, the sharpness of youth, very apparent from Lee, but you can just see that little bit more seniority from Nguyen. A little bit more cleanliness to his work.
Well, he's timing these overhands perfectly. Christian's got to keep that chin tucked. Not let him get caught by one of these big overhand rights, or lefts for that matter.
Christian Lee hasn't seen an opponent like this in the ONE Championship game, so that was a good right hand, and it sent Nguyen stumbling, and Nguyen's in trouble. And Lee just follows up. And Nguyen counts on this. This could be his opportunity. Gets in close, that head is exposed to possible knees. Lee bounces back up, but he goes back down again. He's certainly shaken up.
Christian's hurt, Steve. Christian's hurt. Big left hook landed by Nguyen, started this onslaught, and Nguyen is jumping all over it.
Could already be the Fun 88 fight of the night, this one. You just cannot take your eyes off it.
He's kind of got him in a guillotine here, sort of a modified choke.
Oh, it looks very clean as well.
He's kind of lacing his hand around
under
his
the
bicep.
Chin. I'm not sure how he's getting through this.
Christian's fighting, he might be out. Steve,
he's out.
Fake early there from Ramazanov. Look how he towers, 10 centimeters taller than Ognjen Topic. Two superb Muay Thai world champions in the circle at the moment.
Like feints already from Ramazanov. He utilizes that push kick very well. See how he steps in with that push kick? He connects first with the push kick, and then he throws a lot of feints off it.
Topic has to get inside the reach of Ramazanov. That will be the key here. Jab two from Ramazanov. He's got speed, he's got length. And again, the uppercut flipped on the chin of Ognjen Topic. There's the right hand. Topic backed up early here. Ramazanov, a house on fire. Another uppercut, tucked in under the chin. There's a big right hand, backs up the American again.
There's no feeling out process from Ramazanov. He immediately found his range and his distance with that push kick, and he is putting the heat on Topic.
Just digging the balls of the feet into the midsection of Ognjen Topic. Fires the right hand down the center corridor again. Oh, how taste my feet! Smack bang to the kisser of Ognjen Topic. Well, referee Onari puts a count here at Ognjen Topic. It has not been the start the American serve wanted.
Go!
Lances to his corner. They are barking all sorts of instruction, but this is Ramazanov at his finest, at his most aggressive. Ramazanov has come for a quick finish today. Nice hook off the right hand there from Alaverdi. Ramazanov fakes. Oh, the front kick again. It sends Topic down. Go! This is spectacular from Ramazanov. The beanpole, the tower of power, checks the low kick, goes down the center again. Another push kick. Ramazanov, confident, oozing out of every pore. Good high check there from Ramazanov. When he is on, he is on, and he is masterful to watch.
Beautiful job with those hands, closing the
distance. Smack bang, he dropped him for a second time. One more count in this round, it's over. One more knockdown, it's over for Ognjen Topic. Can Ramazanov finish him with 35 seconds to go? Yes, he does. That's good night, Irene. He could make Coffee nervous. Here we go, first round of action. Big height advantage going the way of Pucci. Can he use his reach here?
These are the low kicks. That's what Urrutia said he wants to do. He wants to go after the lead leg of Bruno Pucci to eliminate that. Oh, he tested the chin right there. Caught him with a straight right.
Urrutia said there'll be no feeling out process. And already aiming towards that jawline of Bruno Pucci. Pucci's got to use that long, sticky jab of his Mitch.
Yeah, we gave Bruno Pucci the grappling advantage, but the striking is going to get really intriguing between these two. Who can get off first? Who can utilize that head movement and throw out those punches?
Beautiful tagging left hand there from Urrutia on the front foot. And Pucci circles into the right hand. Doesn't want to be going that way. That's the power hand of the Honey Badger. High right roundhouse from the Brazilian.
Bruno, he's coming in. He's getting tagged by Urrutia. He's got to move that head, utilize some lateral movement. Urrutia's catching him in some wild exchanges here.
They clinch up for the first time. Urrutia's left hand's been doing damage in the striking so far. He's got an overhook on the right arm of Pucci. He looks for a takedown. What a start.
You can see Urrutia just shrugging him off with that whizzer on that left side. He's pushing him away, creating a little bit of space. This first clinch is going to tell us a lot about the grappling capability. Is Bruno Pucci able to control him? But Urrutia was able to throw him off. Look for that big right hand to come again, Michael.
Will it go back to the left to set up that big thumping right hand? Pucci's got to start to get his jab off. And he threads a nice hook there. Does the Brazilian. Urrutia backs him up. There's the left, the old 1-2. Beautiful smack bang with the kisser with the right hand. And Pucci does a quick count of his teeth.
I'd like to see Urrutia go back to that low kick. That was working for him. He's getting a little bit anxious going after the head. But Pucci, because he landed those early strikes.
There was the jab from Pucci. Goes around house kick, lead leg, no switch up to the rib cage. Threads the jab again, does Pucci. A little more flat footed of the two here is Bruno Pucci. Jab two from Urrutia, backs up the Brazilian.
Urrutia's leaving his head up when he's coming in though, so Bruno's able to counter punch him. As long as he keeps moving back, keeps that head movement.
Shoots in for a takedown, nice evasion there from Emilio Urrutia. Do you think Pucci is feeling that pressure of Urrutia constantly coming forward on him here, Mitch?
You know, Bruno Pucci's been the victim of two big knockouts. He's got to be very careful. He might be a little gun-shy when he comes to rushing in. When he sees Urrutia starting to pressure him, he kind of fades back a little bit. He's got to be careful. There's another one. Big right hand that connected.
Left hook, right hand, two-punch combination. Oh, right hand again!
The chin's holding up. Pucci's got to do something. He's got to move.
He's in all sorts of bother. Bruno Pucci may be ripe for the picking.
Look how patient Urrutia is. He's not pulling the trigger too soon. He's calculating. Oh, Bruno Pucci's on rubber legs right now.
Bruno Pucci taking more knocks than a front door here in the first round. And Urrutia sizes him up, drills another right hand to the jaw. You can see the rubber legs, the challenge legs now on Bruno Pucci.
Pucci's getting lit up. He's got to create some movement. Going for the takedown. Oh, he's out!
Come on! It's good night, Irene! Two! Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson, we're here. From Yangon, Myanmar, one championship, Hero's Dream. A definite sellout crowd. And so
submission attempts are coming very close, Michael.
Kalani back to his feet. Oh no, suddenly resets maybe for the choke. Like a true Burmese python wrapping the arms around the neck of Kalani.
They broke the fence.
They take a little tango. Look at the size of the back of Owen Kalani. You could screen a movie on it. Ripped, stripped, and striated as always. Overhook on the left arm from Onlo and Sun.
This is good. He's really good.
Joe Narawak. Look for Narawak to unload his hands. Look for the succulent technique, the quarter angle turns, the pirouettes of the Ferrari of kickboxing, Giorgio Petrosian. Who will face Sami Sona in Tokyo? Good check there from Petrosian. Didn't check the second one. Petrosian southpaw, orthodox stance on Smoking Joe. From Joe, trying to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Checks the low kick from Petrosian. Front kick there from Smoking Joe Nettowak. Petrosian, jab to a hook. Nice front kick from Smoking Joe, looks for the outside lead thigh. Don't forget, folks, to follow us at One Championship across your social media platforms, YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram.
See Smoking Joe's work rate just a little bit higher right now than Petrosian. Petrosian is a little bit more effective in the accuracy department, though. He is landing more effectively. Not a what's landing, having more success as far as the volume is concerned.
The hands of Petrosian have always been phenomenal. Jab from Narawak. Edging forward. Good low check there. Nice evasion, a lean back from Giorgio Petrosian. Hook from Petrosian. Nice little parry there. Outside leg kick. Just missed the target and accidentally connected to the groin of Petrosian. Down the center corridor. Hooking punch from Petrosian. Knees from Smoking Joe Narawak.
Hands right now from Petrosian are extremely accurate, especially coming off that left side.
Narawak did say in the pre-match media that he considers Petrosian as the greatest kickboxer on the planet, the greatest of all time. And tonight would be his chance to dethrone the great one.
Injury time!
Burn strike there. Elias Talaps is calling injury time for Giorgio Petrosian.
Or injury time. Our athlete has up to 3 minutes to return to the action.
You can see just as Narawak starts to go for that inside leg kick, just gets a little bit high there on Petrosian. That was the second time. First time grazed it, second time connected. Injury time on this one. Athlete is allowed up to 3 minutes for medical examination and recovery. If the athlete is unable to resume in the allotted time, an official decision will be given. If we're not past the second round, it's a no contest. Once it gets past the second round, then we go to the judges' scorecards. You can just see that inside leg kick from Smoking Joe caught the cup.
For the right to compete against Sami Sena in the one featherweight kickboxing World Grand Prix Championship Final on October 13 in Tokyo, Japan. And the right to challenge for US$1 million. They recommence here in the first round. Those slick hands of Petrosian versus the legs of Smoking Joe. Outside leg kick from Petrosian. There's the hook and the little quarter angle turn. Tries to thread the left hand. Smoking Joe with the round kick. Then goes upstairs looking for the net. Cracks around the rib cage to Smoking Joe. Goes down the bread basket with the hands.
You can see the deep.
Oh, he drops him with a straight left hand and Joe's down. Oh, Joe's down. He may not get up.
That's it.
He may not get up. It's good night, Irene!
Yuji Shimada gets us underway. This fight brought to you by Petron, fuel for everyone.
Look for Timofey to come out real hard and aggressive. Big punch right there. They both landed.
Will this go beyond the first round then? That's the question we've been asking. Timofey says no, don't really want it to do that. Already landed big right hands and that kick. What can Eduard do? He was warned by Josh about the fast start.
Well, people throw with the power that both these guys are throwing with. They generally don't have good cardio. But Eduard, he's obviously gone the distance. Oh, he's rocked.
They're swinging for the fences.
You can tell Timofey's got a lot of power in his hands.
He really does, and he's quick too, and he puts everything into those punches, doesn't he? I think the first time Eduard went down, he was kind of off balance, but he was knocked off balance, to be fair.
He's been knocked off balance, though, at least twice now in this first 20 seconds, 30 seconds of the round. Timofey's being a little cautious, though. Timofey's setting it up really nice. He's kind of fainting that little bit of a jab coming over the top with the right hand. He's also looking to catch the kick and throw the right hand at the same time. He's done it twice now.
Look for Eduard to kick quite a lot. Another of these wushu fighters. He enjoys, I was just about to say, a spinning back fist. I was going to suggest that he might not have time to throw them in this fight because Timofey looks so up for it and so quick. But no, he's got one off already. He'll do a spinning back kick as well from time to time.
Timofey lands that right hand again. They're still kind of, believe it or not, they're still kind of in the filling out process.
It's the touchiest feeling out process I've ever seen, I think.
One throwing one and two. When they start throwing twos and threes, though, like what I mean by that is they're throwing two and three punch kicks combination.
Right hand from Timofey. Caught Eduard flush.
Another one right there.
Really throws with bad intention, as Mike Tyson used to say, doesn't he?
Timofey's finding that mark, though, every time. It's just a matter before he finds the tip of the chin. You see Eduard looking to set up a spinning back kick or a spinning back fist, something along his line. He's turning his body sideways.
Caught again, I think, there, Eduard. Just puts everything into those right hands, the Russian.
Well, we're halfway through the round, which is about that's longer than he's gone in half of his fights.
Oh, there it is, the spinning back kick.
Just missed. Timofey did the right thing. He stepped in to close the distance, so he wasn't able to get hit with that spinning back kick.
Eduard can take that spinning back kick upstairs as well. This one landed much lower, around the hips.
Whoa. Caught him again with that right hand.
He did. He's got a pretty good chin, Eduard. Cuts fairly frequently.
What Timofey's doing?
Oh, the knee to the head! Wow, that was a devastating finish.
Referee Atsushi Onari gets us underway. The fluorescent trunks on tray. The red and gold on Nutterwatt. This one brought to you by United International Pictures' Mission Impossible Fallout in cinemas July. Body shot nicely done off the lead hand from Smokin' Joe. Then goes to the outside thigh. Checks the inside leg kick. Jab two from Smokin' Joe. Knees are permitted. Elbows are permitted. Front kick there from Joe. Pilot's roundhouse kick. Good roundhouse kick again off the lead leg from Joe and a nice high check. Front kick from Dre. Overhand right from Smokin' Joe, he takes it! Here comes the ball of the trap! Here comes the punishment! Joe with the heavy artillery!
Now, good job by Dre to keep his wits about him when the onslaught was coming down.
Look at these knees from Joe, not about the trajectory!
Stop!
The point of the knee driving into the outside left thigh of Dre. Smokin' Joe, house on fire here in the first round. The uppercut, the elbows, the high kicks.
Michael, you said you wanted to see the Smokin' Joe from Lion Fight, and this is the Smokin' Joe.
Go. Smokin' Joe Nutterwatt opening up on Johan Dre in the first round. There's the right hand. Dre's the right.
Dre's okay to go on.
Go!
Joe pounces on him again. High left roundhouse kick, trying for the headache maker. Joe with the overhand right. Uppercut from Joe. There's the left hand. Smoke and Joe goes to the body. The power, the precision of the Muay Thai monster truck.
Wow, with those small gloves, it is just slicing through the guard of Dre. You can see Johan Dre trying to cover up like he's covered up with big gloves, but there's so little room to get through.
Overhand right from Smoke and Joe. Ties him up, there's the elbow to the orbital. Uppercut elbow.
That was a beautiful redirection there. Came around and just sat Johan Dre down.
Oh, left hand and a right. Johan Dre held his touchdown.
That could be where the similarities end. Look at the low stance that Nguyen has. Ready to spring into action. That's a very unorthodox beginning. I haven't seen that from him before. Takes a kick to the leg and a right hand from the Chinese fighter.
Martin Nguyen knows he has the advantage here on the ground, but Lee Kai Wen has been working so hard. Nice little stuff there. Martin Nguyen went in for the take and a big belly to back suplex there by Lee Kai Wen as he spins but gives up his back there as he attempts the back elbow.
It's a very fast-paced start from Lee.
Don't grab the fingers, don't grab the gloves.
Lee Kai Wen's got big takedowns. He likes those suplexes. Looks Shane will show respect there.
Big bolo right hand, overhand right, like a fast bowler from his home country of Australia. Tried it again. That right hand comes from a way back and he delivers it quickly, just as Lee was coming in. I'll be wary of that next time he jumps into the attack.
Ooh, nice.
Caught him well. Shot. Started off with a knee. The punches came in and then he goes for the takedown, but Nguyen defends it well.
Ooh, what a furious exchange by Lee Kai Wen.
Oh, it all started. Uppercut from Nguyen. As he superb single punch.
Big body kick, but Nguyen answers right back with a right hand of his own.
And the uppercut again. What a rocking blow that is. From Nguyen this time as the counter, and that is the fearsome weapon for the Australian, no question so far. Oh.
Both these fighters have been saying all week how they want to apply pressure and just come forward, and they're both just slamming into each other.
And Nguyen goes down. Tremendous punch from the Chinese man. They are so well matched, these two. What an entertaining brawl.
What a chin on Martin Nguyen to take that shot.
Second time he's shown a great deal of resilience to these hard punches.
That punch echoed around the stadium as Lee Kai Wen attempts to go for a kimura, possibly. He's got kind of a chicken wing there. Just kind of soften him up, Nguyen, with the big body shots there, just thumping on Lee Kai Wen's body. Yeah, he can use this time now to just recover. If he was hurt from that big punch by Lee Kai Wen, Nguyen can just sort of gain his composure and just recover fully. Lee is hurt.
Lee is bleeding from the nose, no doubt from some of the tremendous punching exchanges that these two have got themselves involved in.
Yeah, I think it was that first uppercut, Steve.
Yeah. Will often do damage to a nose and uppercut.
Both these fighters are showing a huge heart and big chin to take shots like that.
We've seen some tremendous punching. Two super uppercuts from Nguyen and a sparkling left hook from Lee. Will they be taking a breather on the deck here, Mitch, or is this just as hard work, only slightly different?
Man, after that shot.
Oh, the kick to the head. Technical ground kick, number two comes in. Number three. Oh, and the left hand there.
Big left hand.
Clean, and another one. And Lee's in trouble.
Oh, now he's jumping all over it. Looks like the break is over, and the rear naked choke is sunk in. He doesn't have the hooks in, so the leverage isn't there, but he can still finish from this. He chooses to let it go and just kind of control the back. He's got to work on that position before he attempts the submission. That is this is an amazing 4 minutes of action here.
The good news is there's still 50 seconds to go in this round if it goes that far, and we've got 2 5-minute rounds after this. It's a great contest.
You can see now he's got one hook in, and he's just choosing to do damage as he slides that second hook in. Now he's in a really good position to unload.
6 right-hand punches in a row coming through. Nguyen on top,
oh, he's
literally
flattened out, and Nguyen is unloading on him.
Olivier Coste is looking closely.
Lee Kai-Wen has got a move. He's got
it's over. The punches came in unanswered. Martin Nguyen extends his record to 6-1.
Eduard Folayang, the former one lightweight world champion. Eddie Alvarez, former UFC and Bellator world champion. Wild hooking punches from both men, but Alvarez may have drawn the short straw on that exchange. Overhand right from Alvarez, trying to lock on a guillotine early here. The wushu striking of Folayang. Hands like slabs of granite. And the leg kicks are thumping. But Alvarez can brawl, can get on the inside and make it a dogfight, make it vicious. The turning back kick from Folayang. He goes to the liver section. Gotta watch the turning liver kicks, gotta watch the cutting side kicks.
I like that left hook of Folayang right now. It's really trying to find a home on Eddie's chin. You can see him testing it, but Eddie says he wants to test Folayang's chin. Folayang's been knocked out tremendously in some of his past matches, and Eddie wants to test that. That movement fading already.
Folayang hooks the punch, then goes the uppercut off the right hand. A high round kick, the spinning back fist, the outside leg kick from Folayang. Putting together the combinations early on is Eduard Folayang of the Philippines.
Like those fans call it.
If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.